streaming services in the Northeast and the world. They give you water, they give you tablets so you can see the bracket, the stream, everyone who's playing, run your own ads, and they will even peel your own clementines for you and give them to you while you're on the microphone. Shout out to Devin from the House of 3000.
Yo, shout out to the House of 3000, bro.
Well, here we go, man. Start off game one. Yeah. Let me go and pump this energy into this match. We already have, oh, the jab reset? Let's go.
Yeah,
and pluck
nice.
Them weeds, boy. We don't want that in my garden.
Yeah, Bobby definitely knows his jab lock setups with Villager. He's very good with Villager, and he knows a lot.
I'd hope
about
so. He played that character only for like the past 5 years.
Yeah, yeah. And Villager definitely got better in this game because of the game's mechanics. Oh, that's just gonna be Dark Wizzy stock there. Yeah. Oh, Mars with the save though, genius. He came out and saved him with the falling up air. Took a little bit of percent for it, but it worked out. Down smash, F smash, not gonna be the stock yet.
Woo!
Yep, up smash gonna take Villager's first stock there. And yeah, this is the thing about this matchup is that it's just gonna be a bunch of zoners, but ZSS and Mario can kill both of these characters fairly early. The down air not taking Mario's stock quite yet.
Wow, and I'm honestly so surprised. Because he got the air dodge out. That could have been a much stronger punish for Mook. But he's not gonna go take that up tilt.
Nice.
KO, everyone
nice
dying
stock from
on the
both
red team.
Of them. Nice stock from blue team.
I'm gonna tell you, Bobby Wasabi. And then, they're just waiting for each other?
Yeah,
okay.
They're talking it out. They had a game plan there. I saw it. But blue team's actually up right now. And Mook only at 101. So this is not a bad percent to be at. But as a light character, you have to be a little scared.
Oh,
down
God.
Smash, yeah. I think down smash is going to play super heavy here. Because especially with Rage now, down smash, F smash, you can kill around like 70 or 80% here. Throwing out the chef because there's not much you can do about it if you're already caught in it. Yeah, the down B, the dare gonna take that early stock from Mook with the bad DI.
And here's the thing, I know Mars is very adept at fighting Game & Watch, right? Whether it's like fighting Q or even if it was Full Bloom 5 where he fought off
Meister.
Against Meister,
yep.
Right? And he was able to secure himself the win there as well. And now Mook, you know, not throw any shade, but isn't quite the caliber of Meister, right?
Yeah, so. Mike's not Mook's not at Meister's level, but Mook is definitely no slouch. He's definitely the best Game & Watch in New England right now, and he has proven himself time and time again to be able to be a player you should be afraid of at least. And you're actually making work of it right now. Villager, Bobby's only on his last stock, but
only on his what now?
Only on his not stock at all. On his fourth stock. Wow, the F smash. I thought it killed Mars, but he killed himself though, so that is unlucky. And now Bobby on his fourth stock here. He has to play against two characters that are super aggro, and
okay.
He just ran out of energy on that uppie. He ran out of gas on his balloons.
That was something.
That was definitely a match that happened in front of our eyes for a few minutes.
Takes the stock and immediately forward smashes his partner. I mean, that's cool.
Yeah, that's the Exiled Classic. Take the stock and kill your teammate. I'm doing this on my own, big dog.
Yeah, no, that was honestly kind of strange. We're just looking at the... Yeah, I guess. Oh, yeah. he popped under the balloons, it looked like.
Oh, did he? Yeah, and then he just ran out again. Because he had to uppie across the bottom of the stage.
Yeah.
And then did another uppie and popped the balloons.
Yeah, you can see him come down. Yeah.
Yeah. He didn't even get the chance. But we're going to see the same characters going into game two here. I think this is still definitely honestly doable for blue team. They were making pretty good work of Mars Wizzy the first game.
It started off really
close,
strong.
But they had the adaptation. Game two going to Yoshi's story here and a smaller stage to make up for.
Okay.
Oh, yep. He definitely was off stage and almost got hit by the... What is happening?
I really don't know.
Is this a button check? I feel like I'm bugging.
Oh, yo, let's go. Yo, Mom. Bobby out there boxing with the best of them.
Yeah. Squaring up right now.
Clap, 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 clap. There we go. Nair. Ooh, jab, jab. Ooh, I like that. That could have been like a cute little reset or something.
Yeah.
Bobby just going balls to the wall here. It's like you ever play Icy Tower?
I don't know what that is.
It's like one of those games where you just try to, there's platforms that randomly spawn. You try to get as high as you can, and you just kind of spin in a circle. That's what the Villager neutral air is, the Icy Tower. But
it's just the Ferris wheel. Merry-go-round indeed. You just spin around over and over.
There we go.
Uppie out of shield.
Yes.
Yeah, Dark Wizzy was telling me about it, actually. Mario's uppie out of shield is frame 3, he said. And it's just super good. There's a lot of percent. And if you get the up air uppie, it could just be a super early stock. But speaking of uppies, Mars upping Bobby there to take his first stock.
There we go, man. Oh,
down
clean.
Smash, F smash. Yep, that's going to be Dark Wizzy's first stock gone. And now We're back to even. Two stocks apiece per player. Two people at a higher percent. This is definitely a scary position. If Mook gets a down smash on Mars, that's just going to be the stock. But the same thing will happen if Mars gets a down smash on Mook. Oh, the down air just catching the landing. Down air is just a super good option to oppress anyone trying to approach you with an aerial. And Mario smash taking Mook stock. There's so many stocks being traded back to back. Oh!
He was able to spike.
My god.
He needs to save.
Oh, that was
perfect.
So, that was so smart for Mook because he had Dark Wizzy like recovering low, but if he upbeat, he would have hit him and saved him. So he just waited, and then as soon as Dark Wizzy was too low, Bobby dropped the Lloyd and then saved him from the air dodge. So that was super smart for Blue Team.
Cleanest teamwork I've seen yet today.
Yeah, that was super smart too. Looks like Mars and Dark Wizzy aren't the only ones with super good team chop right now. This is definitely really good. The four pummels on the back, though, not going to take it quite yet. Villager can live for a pretty long time if you don't have anything to true confirm. You have the Nair. Oh no, Mars has to eat that stock again. Yeah, he just air dodged right after the Nair and just fell and died for it. And this is actually looking really good for Blue Team right now. I won't lie to you.
Yeah, I mean, granted for Dark Wizzy, he really just needs like two up smashes to connect. And then he has himself in a 1v1, and then he's really able to work from there. But we're going to see if he's able to find those. Oh, my goodness. And hatchet?
Oh, he wanted the down smash there. Yeah, he just ended up getting single jab, though. But if Mook gets a down smash right now, that's just going to be the stock.
Okay, there's one.
There's one stock. Now, but now Bobby's on his last stock
back
at
here,
zero.
Right? Oh.
Nice, hit him with the uppie again.
Oh,
he got
his jump back.
Yeah, that's just going to be it. Good stuff to Mook and Bobby for taking game two. They definitely kept their composure there. There's a lot of things happening on the screen, a lot of deaths just happening back and forth.
Well, yeah, and especially the beginning of that. I mean,
it was just
two out of three stocks from Mars for SDs, right? Where he
that
first one.
Unlucky.
And especially on stages like this, like I know Yoshi's Island Brawl is Mars' favorite stage, thinks it's DSS's best stage. He just likes the walls on the side because then she can like do flip. And then wall jump and do all kinds of crazy
shenanigans.
There's
a lot of ways to be able for ZS to stall off stage.
So it looked like he just kind of like messed up in the beginning there, which was very uncharacteristic of him. But he should be fighting back quite easily in this game too. So I'm kind of sweating. Even though they won that game, I'm still sweating for Bobby Wasabi and Mook there. I still think that Dark Wizzy and Mars should have no problem securing the second game.
Mook and Bobby, though, they're holding their ground super
well. You can't sleep
on
them, though. Especially, Mook... definitely, as I said before, best game in Washington, New England. Strong contender, Bobby Wasabi. Also, just been doing, both of these players have been doing pretty well for themselves. Bobby, especially, as of late. And I feel like,
they're on the rise right now. This is super good.
But we're going to see, man. I feel like Dark Wizzy's in the same vein. I mean, toward the end of Smash 4, Dark Wizzy was always kind of like, you put him in the featured players list on your tournament if you had him.
Yep.
But he wasn't PGR until like the very end, right?
Yep.
All-time PGR. He was never quite able to get there. But now going into Ultimate, he's probably secured himself as like a top 20, 25 player at this point.
Yeah,
so he's
right now Dark Wizzy's just holding his ground super well.
Especially after
himself.
That crowd performance.
Yep, he's proven himself super well here. And Game 3, we're going to Battlefield. I know this is a favorite stage for Villager, a favorite stage for Mario, and a favorite stage for ZSS. Game & Watch, I'm not sure about, but I think he could work out in his favor as well. So this is definitely going to be interesting. Mars already at 62%, way higher than he wants to be compared to everyone else on the screen right now.
You see, Mook's just bullying him with these fires out of shield.
Yeah.
Which is crazy. Isn't it stupid that that trampoline is called fire?
Yeah.
I was looking it up in the training mode, and it's like, the Game & Watch's up special is called fire! Exclamation point. And I'm like, okay.
It's based off of it's based off the Game & Watch
game,
Fire.
It is. Like the hydrants, right? They have the little...
bounce them off the trampolines, so...
Yeah, exactly. The little
fireman. Oh, that was a nice tech from Bobby. He was a... That was just a scary, like, hard to react to, too, because it was just immediate runoff back air and then into the instant tech. He had him, almost had him the F smash there, but that was just smart using the flip kick to be able to get away from the bowling ball. As a dash attack, this could just set up for an edge guard situation here. Back air? No, he went for the uppie instead to get away from the fireball.
I think you see the down smash. Oh my god.
Yeah, down smash is just super scary here. You don't want to get caught by it, but you have to respect it too. So Dark Wizzy was charging F smash there, and then Mook saw it, went in for his own F smash. But then after he let go of the F smash, Dark Wizzy like went forward, so Mook missed his F smash. That was just funny.
You have to be careful though, because while he does love throwing out the down smashes, right, Mook, Dark Wizzy is playing Mario, who has some of the best out of shield options in the game.
Yep.
We're talking about that super jump punch out of shield. He does have that up smash out of shield as well. So it's really hard to kind of try and poke it. Oh my god. Okay.
Yeah,
it just kind of went to Wasabi. We'll take it.
Yeah. And right now, Mars just waiting. He doesn't want to approach at all. He's at 150. He's just waiting on the platform. He doesn't want to have to approach. He doesn't want to do too anything super aggro and lose his stock lead here.
But that's weird. It's like the blue team didn't even try to put pressure onto him. They just let him wait. It's,
yeah. Bobby sat there and started planting his tree instead, waiting for an approach, because he knew he could set up for anti-projectiles with the tree. But Mook on his last stock right now. Bobby at 50 on his second. This is definitely a hard lead to be able to come back to.
Beautiful handoff from Mars to Dark Wizzy. Dark Wizzy racking up some damage onto the blue team as well, and just trying to work his way in. Dark Wizzy being a sheer aggressor right now. Oh no, he should be fine.
It wasn't a mean spike. This is a scary position. Yep, he's just stuffing him away. He said, "Get out of my face. No tears for you."
He's looking for one more hit here. Bobby, what's up?
Nice
down
uppie.
Below.
That was a nice parry uppie from Mook right there. That was genius.
Around the world in 80 days.
Yeah.
Plasma Whip coming out. Bobby Wasabi can't find the punish, throwing out these forward smashes. Mars still on the prowl as Bobby Wasabi looking to find an answer here. Needs to find a KO. Mars still has three stocks.
Oh, nice
finally.
Up air. Finally taking Mars' first stock, but it might be too little too late here. Bobby on at 130 on his second. Mook at 87 on his last. Now both on their last, but this is just a scary position to be in. They're going to have to... Nice back air.
Beautiful.
Yep, that's going to take the stock. Nice. And now we have three on their last stock. Mars on his second stock at super little percent. So they're going to have to... He's going to have to... Get the 9 when he got hit out of it. Oh, that could have been good too. That's unlucky. But this is definitely... We're going to have to see some plays from blue team here.
Yeah, they're definitely with their backs against the rope here. No bucket usage. There goes Mook, and it's all up to young Mobe Wasabi.
Bobby Wasabi, Void Slayer 69. It's up to him. He goes for the air dodge read down smash. Not gonna get it.
Oh, beautiful nice parry.
Yeah, this is a hard position to be in, because now he's just gonna have to sit here and wait on ledge and not do anything super overcommittal. And you don't really have too many options with a villager that are super committal.
Right.
Other than a neutral move and not an aerial. But, that was definitely something that happened.
That's just one thing, man. You know, Bobby, he's managed to get a hit here and there, but it doesn't matter because someone is always ready and waiting. Mars going out deep with the back air to go out and confirm that KO as well. Mars and Dark Wizzy will be moving on further into the winner's bracket. No surprise there, but we did have an immaculate showing coming out from Mook and Bobby Wasabi there. They did a really good job of contending with some of the top seeds of this tournament.
Yeah, they kept it pretty close.
They
it
did.
Went to game three, despite what happened during game two, whatever happened in game two. They kept
sucks.
It super close, even up until game three. It wasn't super doable, but if there was a little bit of cleanup on both their ends, it definitely could have been much closer. And